what I tend to do is do a couple of layers. It's really about studying the picture and seeing what colour it is and how it looks. And use the
what sort of time factor are you looking at to create one of your prints?
Probably, let's just think, the Jersey cow, about 50 continuous hours, if you were going to...
That's for the cow. How about the hair?
Yeah, well, probably about 45 hours, something like that. You can do it quicker, though. I mean, like, today we've got 2 hours.
So you don't have to let it dry, then, between layers?
No, and that's the, you know... I mean, I do oil paints. I do city scenes with oil paints, Chinatown and things like that. And once I've been using the acrylic inks for a little while, I go back to the oil and say, oh my goodness, I have to wait for this layer to dry and I have to wait for that layer to dry. And I get quite impatient. So that's just the transparent burnt umber and the white again. And I'm just going to... See what I mean by just building up bit by bit. Let's use some of the burnt sienna. It's got a nice ruddy colour. And because they're transparent, it just takes on that colour underneath, which is really nice. Do it a bit quicker as possible. Let's get the big brush out. And with the same as acrylic ink as with oils, you can glaze. So I could go over the transparent burnt umber and you can see the difference that's making already. It really brightens it up. So you can use glazes like you would with oil paints. Makes a bit of a difference, doesn't it, though, that colour? Picture, you can just see some lighter bits, so some little dots will do that there. As I say, you're going to have more time, so you're going to be able to put a little bit more detail on that. When you're at home, if you haven't got any acrylic inks, you could use acrylic paint if you've got it and water it down as much as you can. The difference between the acrylic inks and the acrylic paints is the acrylic ink has got a lot more pigment in it. So when you're watering down acrylic inks, they're not going to be as strong and vibrant. These are light fast as well, so you could, if you had a painting and you had it in the conservatory, that would be fine. Quite tolerant to light. But I'll let you go away and have a go. Raw sienna really, down first, and then the colours on top. Thank you.
Thank you.
So I've put the raw sienna over the whole of it, just to give it a bit of a background colour.
I know that, it's okay.
And then we've obviously got darker bits here.
So if they use opaque ones,
some white bits along here.
Yeah, okay. Or you can go with the
and some transparent burnt
umber. Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah.
The more you work with it, the more you'll see the colours yourself anyway. But I've done the raw sienna underneath, then transparent burnt umber. So this will be all of this bit here.
That's fine though. I think that's one of the things I love about it.
Yeah.
You can really do what
you
want. Then a little bit of the black. Not as much of it, just a little bit.
I haven't got the eyes somehow.
Do each individual?
I know.
So doing that one too. And when I say about going back as a four, so you've obviously got three colours, the raw sienna, transparent burnt umber and the black.
Where is it?
But then you can go again with the transparent and the straight top. And then you're building up lots of layers. So and it's not in any particular, you can see I'm not doing any particular stroke, just pulling it backwards, but I'm going in this direction. It seems easy to work upside down.
Oh, yeah.
It is. Yeah. And don't feel afraid to. So if you're working that way, but then I want to pull this out, then just turn it round, yeah. Turn your picture around. And then I'm working to it this way. But actually, if you turn it upside down, you're not seeing a hair, you're seeing a shape. So it's a lot easier to do. If you turn it down that way, you're actually seeing the face, and you're not seeing that shape. So you do need to turn it that way when it gets good. And then I'm just going to put in some. It's kind of. So that's the transparent burnt umber and white. So that would be, so that would be that whole entire section then. And then down here. Got this bit here, which you could use the transparent burnt umber and white mixed. And that again, it's going in this direction. And you're going to have some more up here as well. And this bit around here. Then for the rest, got your base colour and then your transparent burnt umber. When I was on a computer, which is on a laptop, but no, this is fine. So you can see them, the colour differences there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're just going to build it up like that, so it's all just filled with butter.
So we'll see the third hand,
yeah. More sienna on the bottom, then transparent burnt umber, lots of little lines. And then I change to silver. Yours is a cousin, isn't it? And then we had the transparent burnt umber and the white pressed together. Which makes it nice. It's just flipped on as well.
Yeah.
I know you're doing
that, but
it's a show. Yes. How would you work? Do you work from different areas?
I would go from ears down.
Yeah.
I do the eye first, always do the eye first, and then do the ears.
Is that a reference point?
The eye is, as long as you get the eye just right, it doesn't really matter what you do to the rest, to be quite honest. I mean, this, you could really start picking his ears up in, you know, in all directions, and the hair on the side, you could, I mean, it's not like it on the picture, but you could really start flicking them out and it would still look okay.
Yeah.
So as long as you've got the eye right, everything else is fine. But because I'm right-handed, I start this side.
Yeah.
Well,
the eyes
always go down. How is it? I always do the eye first, but I would go back into that because you know you're gonna go over it a little bit. And also, once you've done all this, that might not be the right colour, it might not be quite strong enough, so you'd go back to the eye, just put in some other little bits.
Folks, we're winding up there. It's been really quite good. I've never used it before. I've never tried something.
You can see.
So, I'm quite intrigued by how they work.
You should have shared.
Yes. So, thank you, Julie, for enjoying the evening.
Thank you.
Very instructive. I'm sure some of us will carry on doing this. Thank you very much.
Cellophane is stopping it.